Yes, good morning children. So let us study a little more about inductive effect. Okay, I suppose you must have understood yesterday how inductive effect is decided for different groups. Okay, so I gave you an order with respect to hydrogen, which are all the groups which are more electron releasing with respect to hydrogen, same way which are more electron withdrawing relative to hydrogen. Okay, so based on that you decide whether it is showing minus I effect or plus I effect. Okay, now let me once again show you that order. The order is here. So here NO2 is much more electron withdrawing than CN group, than COOH, than all the halogens, and then relative to hydrogen we saw these are all more electron withdrawing than hydrogen. Okay, these are all more electron withdrawing than hydrogen, electron withdrawing, that is why you call it as minus I effect. Apni taraf negative charge ko khichna, theek hai, that is why it is minus I effect. And there are certain groups which are more electron releasing than hydrogen. They are all the alkyl groups, tertiary alkyl, secondary alkyl, primary alkyl, then methyl relative to hydrogen. These are all more electron releasing. Electron releasing means it pushes the electrons away from it. Okay, that is called as electron releasing group. And these are electron withdrawing. It takes the electron towards itself. Okay. So this is minus I and plus I effect. Now based on this, let us see a few applications to understand this. Now say for example, you have CH3, CH2, O negative, and on the other side you are having NO2, CH2, CH2, O negative. Okay, now here you are having only alkyl group and oxygen with a negative charge, and you know very well that alkyl group is electron releasing, it is electron pushing, it pushes the electron away from it, whereas this NO2 group is highly electron withdrawing. You saw in the order NO2 was having the highest power to withdraw the electrons towards itself. So this is electron withdrawing, this is electron releasing. So what this will do, this will push the electron towards oxygen, and this oxygen is already having a negative charge, and if more and more electrons are pushed from this side towards oxygen, so the electron density over oxygen will increase, it will increase, then what will happen, it will destabilize the complete species. Whereas here what happens, this NO2 is pulling the electron towards itself. Of course, yahan pe bhi ek alkyl group hai, but this is more electron withdrawing. So the negative charge on oxygen is dispersed throughout the molecule because of the NO2 group. Because of the electron withdrawing nature of this NO2 group, the negative charge on oxygen is being pulled towards this side. Is it not? It is pulled towards this side. Whereas the electron density is pushed towards oxygen. Is that clear? So more and more of electron density on oxygen, then this will destabilize the species. Whereas there is dispersal of negative charge throughout the molecule because of this NO2 group. So this will be more stable. Okay, this will be less stable. Okay. Now let me give you another. I gave you yesterday CH3 COOH, and on the other side CH2 Cl COOH. Okay, now here this is electron releasing, whereas this chlorine is electron withdrawing, it is pulling the electron towards itself. So what will happen? The ionization of hydroxyl group. Let me show it once again. Since electron releasing group is there on this side, then what will happen? This oxygen will get electron density because of the electron releasing nature of this. Okay. Now, what is the basic nature of oxygen? To pull electron towards itself, because it is electronegative. So what it has to, either it has to pull from here, or if somebody is giving voluntarily from this side, then is oxygen ko is hydrogen se lena, matlab it is not necessary to take it from hydrogen when somebody is giving voluntarily. Okay, so this OH group, it ionizes partially, the ionization is not complete, whereas here the Cl is pulling. So what happens? ऑक्सीजन को अपने आप को बचाने के लिए हाइड्रोजन से लेना होगा, ठीक है? विद द रिजल्ट व्हाट हैपेंस, दिस ओएच ग्रुप इट क्लीव्स और इट ब्रेक्स बिकॉज ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन विड्रॉइंग नेचर ऑफ क्लोरीन. बिकॉज ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन विड्रॉइंग ग्रुप इन द मॉलिक्यूल, दिस ओएच ग्रुप ब्रेक्स इजिली, वेयर एज बिकॉज ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन रिलीजिंग ग्रुप हियर, दिस ओएच ग्रुप इट डिसोसिएट्स पार्शियली. नाउ इफ इट इज डिसोसिएशिंग पार्शियली, दैट मीन्स एच प्लस इज नॉट रिलीज्ड इनटू द सॉल्यूशन. That means it is less acidic. Whereas, because of this chlorine, this OH will easily break or it will dissociate and H plus will be released in solution. So, you say that acetic acid is less acidic than chloroacetic acid. Okay, so how you will say? You will say, first of all, based on electron releasing group on this molecule, and electron withdrawing group of this molecule. Indicate that first. Then you will say presence of electron releasing group decreases OH polarity. Okay? OH polarity. Polarity means what? Separation of charges. So, OH polarity, separation of charges, it is minimized, it is decreasing in the presence of electron withdrawing group. With the result, H plus is not coming out in solution, okay? Decreases OH polarity and hence acetic acid shows lesser acidic strength. Okay, whereas presence of electron withdrawing group increases OH polarity. Look, dear children, this is the key word in the answer. Okay, if you don't write this, then you are not going to score. Okay, presence of electron withdrawing group increases OH polarity and thus increases acidic strength. Okay, I suppose you are clear. Okay, now let me give you another. Say, for example, I have phenol and paranitrophenol. Okay, now here again, you know, nitro group is electron withdrawing, so presence of electron withdrawing group will increase OH polarity, so this will be more acidic than this. Benzene is also electron withdrawing because of the pi electron cloud. Three pi bonds are there inside the benzene ring, is it not? This you know it. There are alternate double and single bonds in benzene ring. So this pi electron cloud, it will also, the because of resonance, the electrons will be pulled towards benzene ring. That I will discuss with you in the next concept. Okay, so you just understand now, presence of electron withdrawing group, it increases OH polarity, so phenol is less acidic than paranitrophenol. Phenol is less acidic than paranitrophenol. Okay, say the same way, if I take CH3 CO OH, and then CH2, CH3, CO, OH. Supposing you take like this. Now, isme kya hoga? This is also electron releasing. This is also electron releasing. Any alkyl group is electron releasing for that matter. So, in this case, how do we decide? This shows that the increase in alkyl chain will increase the electron releasing character. So, this will be more acidic than this. Okay, here there is only one methyl group. Here there is ethyl group. The length of the carbon chain has increased. So, with increase in alkyl chain, what will happen? The electron pushing effect will also increase. So, this will be isme OH polarity aur kam ho jayega. Whereas, isme ek hi group hone se OH polarity phir bhi kehne layak hogi. So, this will be more acidic than this. Now, if you consider formic acid and acetic acid, then formic acid is much more acidic than acetic acid. Why? Because there is no electron releasing group. Hydrogen is neither electron releasing nor electron withdrawing. Okay. So here there is no such group will to decrease the polarity. So formic acid is said to be more acidic than acetic acid. Okay. Then what else we can talk about? Okay. Let me tell you. Say you have methyl paramethylphenol or 4-methylphenol and nitrophenol and phenol. Supposing you have to compare the acidic strength of these three. Okay. Now say this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Now how do we decide? Here CH3 group is electron releasing. So, electron releasing group will decrease OH polarity. Electron withdrawing group will increase OH polarity. Now, here there is neither electron withdrawing nor electron releasing. Koi extra group isme hai nahi. Okay. So, this 1 will be less acidic than 3. 3 will be less acidic than 2. Okay. So, this is the order of acidic strength.